Now, how do I define the vector? That means, how do I say, if I tell you the length of the vector, then what all things do I do to specify the direction of the vector? Okay. Now you see, if we were dealing with a 2D, if it was a 2D vector and I had told you the length of the vector, then I need to define only one more thing. What is that? It is, what is the angle it makes with the positive direction of the x-axis? So if I tell you this is a 5 unit length, okay, it's 5 unit in length, and that unit may be say centimeter, kilometers or whatever, according to scale it can be whatever, and it is making an angle of 30 degree with the positive direction of the x-axis, you immediately understand that this is the vector. So the vector can be fixed, it can be made unique by in a 2D, the vector can be made unique, vector can be completely defined, right? Completely defined if its magnitude and the angle that it makes with positive direction of x-axis is known. Okay, what is known? So this is my x-axis, this is my y-axis. Now what do I do for a 3D? If I want the same thing to happen in a 3D, what do I do? See, if I define, this is my x-axis, this is my x-axis, I tell you that the length of the vector is this, and I say it is making an angle of, this is obviously the y-axis, I say it is making an angle of say 30 degree with the x-axis. So since earlier this fellow was jammed here, right, in the plane, it was jammed, but in the 3D we are not jammed, we can go like this, see, right? It, see, all these vectors, they are making an angle of 30 degree, right? That means if I keep this fixed and I rotate this in a cone, all of them will make an angle of 30 degree. So I have still not defined the vector. Okay, I have still not defined the vector. Don't write anything when I'm saying something. We have try to understand. I have still not defined the vector. Okay, so I've given you the length, I've given you some angle. Okay, now what happens? Our common sense says that fine, maybe you define an angle with respect to y-axis also. Okay, you define an angle with y-axis also. So if I say this is 30 and I say that this is 45, you see, so it cannot happen in this plane. This cannot happen in this plane. So obviously this will be 60 if it is in the same plane. But if it starts maybe moving like this or moving like this, okay, or moving like this, somewhere you might find that it is 45 or maybe say 70 or 80 or 100. Okay, so what happens now if that happens? So what we do, we actually specify all the three angles that a vector makes with the x, y, z to do away with the ambiguity. You'll soon see that you will require only two of them. The third will already be defined. You just cannot fix all of them three, all three of them independently. Okay, you just cannot. Okay, so we, what we do, we to make things pretty unambiguous, we define the angle that it makes with all the positive direction of the coordinate axis. Okay, so let us try to see. So we have got a vector like this. You see this, and this is my x axis. So you'll specify this angle. Okay, you'll specify this angle that it's making with the x axis. Then that angle that it's making with the y axis. So you, let me show it to you. These are the axes. Okay, these are the axes. Okay. But difficult to hold all three. Maybe like this I can hold. It's like this. So what you do, this is your vector, so you specify this angle. Okay, this angle is the angle with the x axis, this angle is the angle with the y axis, and this is the angle with the z axis, and we define it to be alpha, beta and gamma. We call them. So it is making some angle with x axis, this we call alpha. It's making some other angle with y axis, this we call beta, and it is making some angle like this with the z axis, this we call gamma. Okay. Now just try to understand. We had just seen that the length OE square is equal to x square plus y square plus z square. That's why I've deliberately left this here. Now try to think. I'll show you this again. So it is this. This is my vector. Okay. Now this angle that it is making, this angle that it is making with the x axis is known to me. So what is this? If this is OE, if this length is OE, right? OE is the length. Then OE, this pen, okay, and this blue pen, and this green pen, they are making a right angle. Do we see that? They are making a right angle. And the right angle where they are making the 90 degree? Here. Yahan pe. This is 90 degree. Yeah, yahan pe, haan, yahan. Okay. So what happens? That is OE. This angle is alpha. Okay, because it is making it with x axis towards me. Just for showing it to you, I have turned it this way. So this is alpha. So I have got a right angle triangle in which this blue pen is x, this red pen is OE. And this, the angle between the red pen and the blue pen is alpha. Do we understand that? So what happens? So I have got a right angle triangle in which I have an OE. Okay, OE. This is alpha. Or make it, I don't know. This is alpha and this is x. This is OE. Now what does it mean? It means that OE cos alpha is equal to x. OE into cos alpha, is it not? Base upon hypotenuse is equal to, so I'll do that. X upon OE equal to cos alpha, then you'll understand. X is OE cos alpha. Do we get that? Now it is again forming an angle beta with this, beta with y axis. This is my y axis, right? This vertical is my y axis. So this is making an angle beta with this. Again, I have got a right angle triangle. You see, this is y, this is y, this green pen and blue pen are forming a right angle triangle here. Here, you understand? So I have got another triangle in which बता दीजिए OE in which there is OE and there is an angle beta that it makes with this. So this is beta and this is y. Okay, so this becomes what? OE base. This becomes base. The adjacent side becomes base. Base upon hypotenuse. Y upon OE is equal to cos beta. So y becomes OE cos beta. And similarly, z upon OE will become cos gamma. Do I need to show that? This is like that. So this is the z. Okay, so this triangle is forming a 90 degree. If you see that, this forming a 90 degree here. Okay, and this angle with the z axis, this inside, this angle is z. Okay, so this is side z. Between z and OE, they are making an angle of, between z and OE, they are making an angle of gamma. This z, positive direction of z axis, and OE. So we have another triangle where it's kind of this is my z and OE, it was making an angle gamma. Obviously they are differently oriented, it was oriented like that, okay, like this. So z upon OE is cos gamma, so z is equal to OE cos gamma. Now these cos alphas, cos betas and cos gammas are called the direction cosines. They are called direction cosines. Okay, direction cosines. Why? Because they help you set up the direction, and they are actually cos of angles. And they are actually cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma. What is alpha? Alpha is the angle that it makes with x axis. Beta is the angle that it makes with y axis. Gamma is the angle that it makes with z axis. So, but and they are in short named LMN. Okay, LMN. This is a perfect convention. It's not something, if you write LMN, it is meant that you are writing cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma. We get the point? Fine. So if it is LMN, then we are actually saying, now let us see what happens. So cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma, direction cosines. I may write that alpha is the angle that vector makes with positive direction of x axis. Okay, and beta is the angle that vector makes with positive direction of y axis, and gamma is the angle that vector makes with positive direction of z axis. We understand? So what happens if I add them, square them and add them? What happens if I do x square plus y square plus z square? I get OE square cos square alpha plus OE square cos square beta plus OE square cos square gamma. And if I take out my OE square, or I can replace it by L square plus M square plus N square, since cos alpha beta gamma like that. Okay. And what is my OE square? That is actually x square plus y square plus z square. So it becomes something like that. So what does it give me? They cancel. And it gives me that L square plus M square plus N square is equal to 1. You see? It tells you that we are making an angle of, if alpha, beta, gamma, cos of them are called LMN, and if you square them up and add them, they'll give you 1. Okay, so all the three of them cannot be independently set. If I set two of them, the third automatically becomes defined. Okay, the third automatically becomes defined. So in the earlier case, when I was saying that L is my alpha is about 30 and M is say 45, then what happens? My N will automatically get fixed. So if it was making an angle of 30 degree, cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So root 3 by 2 whole square plus 1 by root 2 whole square cos 45 plus N square is equal to 1. Okay, so this is 3 by 4 and this is 1 by 2. This is 1 by 2. Now this thing will not be possible. Why? This 3 by 4, 1 minus 3 by 4 will give you what? No, this is possible. Quite possible. So that will give you what? 3 by 4 plus 1 by 2 plus n square. No, it is not possible. So it is giving you what? 3 by 4 is 75% plus half. Now that gives you a negative value and you will have no n such that square of it will be a negative quantity. So you cannot set alpha as 30 and beta as 45. You just cannot. Okay. So you understand? Or if you have set 2, it will immediately tell you what is the angle that it will make with the z axis. Okay. We understand that. So we get that somehow your x upon r, x upon the length of the vector. See the magnitude, if r is a vector, then mod r or simply r, if you just remove that arrow sign from above the head of that vector, that starts represents the magnitude of the vector. The magnitude of the vector. Okay? Mod r or simply r represents the magnitude of the vector. Okay? So what I am saying, x upon r is equal to cos alpha, y upon r is equal to cos beta, and z upon r is equal to cos gamma. Be conversant with this because it keeps on getting used in the formula every now and then.